Then this was the place where the Sahaba have been praying towards Masjid al-Aqsa, and they changed during the prayer towards Masjid al-Haram. So if someone is not he prayed in the wrong direction and he remembered during the Salah that he prayed in the wrong direction, he can change in the Salah. Or if someone saw that a person is directing to a wrong direction, he can change his position. But if one person prayed to a wrong direction and the Salah is finished, then he doesn't need to pray the Salah again, to repeat the Salah. Because it happened at the time of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that some Sahaba, they were traveling and there have been a lot of fog, you know, fog. So they said it was very very heavy fog, so that if you put your hand like this, you don't see your hand. And the time of Salah come, so we started praying Salat al-Jama'ah. And after we finished the Salah, the fog went away. So we found that each one of us, he prayed to a different direction. This one prayed to this, this one prayed to this. Different direction, everyone. So when we came to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he did not tell us to do the Salah again. As long as it was by mistake. You don't need to repeat the Salah. So this is what you say to those people who are telling that we worship the Kaaba. We pray towards the Kaaba, but if someone forgot and he didn't pray towards the Kaaba, then he doesn't need to repeat the Salah. Why? Because we don't pray for to the Kaaba, we pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So no one has the right to swear with the Kaaba. The Kaaba is a building, it's some rocks. But the place is holy place. But it doesn't mean that, for example, the stones of the Kaaba, you can do something like magic with those stones. No, those stones are stones. Nothing but stones. But why we pray to those stones? Towards those stones? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us so. Not because those stones have something special, or it has some power or something. No, there is no power in those stones. Even Al-Hajar al-Aswad, the Nabi Umar radiallahu anhu, because it is sunnah, when you do tawaf and you reach Al-Hajar al-Aswad, you kiss Al-Hajar al-Aswad, the black stone. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do this because he said that this stone is from Jannah. It's not from earth. This stone is from Jannah. And it was white. It was more white than the milk. It was more white than milk. But because of the sins of people, it became black. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to kiss Al-Hajar al-Aswad when he do tawaf. So Umar radiallahu anhu used to kiss Al-Hajar al-Aswad also when he do tawaf. And before he kissed Al-Hajar al-Aswad, Umar radiallahu anhu, he talked to this stone. He say, "Wallahi, I know that you are only a stone. You don't give any harm or benefit. And if I did not see Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kiss you, I will not kiss you." So every time Umar radiallahu anhu, he do this. He tell the stone first, "I know that you are only a stone, that you don't give harm or benefit, and if I did not see Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kissing you, I will not kiss you." So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was Khalifa after Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he saw Umar radiallahu anhu always do this, he told him, "Don't do this, you always stand first, and maybe other people want to kiss the stone, and you spend a lot of time talking to the stone first before kissing it." So Umar radiallahu anhu always remind himself that there is nothing special for this stone. It is a stone, nothing but a stone. You cannot get power from this stone. So only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kissed this stone because it is from Jannah, but it does not give any harm or benefit. So that's why it is ignorance. Or some Muslims, when they go to Mecca, I saw some brothers, especially from Pakistan and Africa, they fight each other, fight and beat, punish people to go and kiss the stone. He think that if he did not kiss the stone, he will lose a lot of things. It's only sunnah. But to hit and punish people, this is haram. Maybe you lose your hajj. Your hajj, you spend a lot of money and a lot of effort, and wal'adhu billah, you punch one Muslim in his face to go and kiss the stone, all of your hajj finish. all of the Hajj is finished. You don't get any ajr. You don't get any forgiveness from Hajj if you beat one Muslim or if you tell bad thing to one Muslim. So it is very bad ignorance. Some Muslims beside the Kaaba, they try to do like this and like this and like this to go and kiss the stone. And some women they do with the men. I saw one woman from Pakistan, where her son is pulling her to go and kiss the stone, and people are very crowded, and she's between the men, and it's very painful. Of course, she's a woman, she's weak, and the woman's body cannot be put between men like this. Is haram, and her hijab fall down, and she's. So it is very big ignorance. So this, because of the problem in the belief, if this person believes that this stone has something very special, no, it is a stone. What the stone can do for you? Nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to pray towards this stone. So it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has the power, not the stone. So it's very important when why Nabi sallallahu alaihi told us not to swear with anything other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because our creator is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not anything else. And we have to remember that anything cannot give harm or benefit to us unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides that this thing will give us some harm or give us some benefit. So meaning that it is haram to swear with anything other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is haram, it is a big haram, and it can put you in Jahannam to swear even with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and take the right of one Muslim to give to some other person or to give it to yourself. And it is haram for you to sell more is to swear, wallahi, this thing is good, this thing is from that place, and it is, and you know that it is low quality. All of this can take you to Jahannam. But the most dangerous is to swear with something or someone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is led to kufr wal a'udhu billah. Any questions? No question? Okay. Think bye, inshallah. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، صل على محمد في الآخرين، صل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا على من عادانا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا، ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا منتهى أملنا، ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين، واكشف الهم والغم والحزن والأسقام والأوجاع وأسباب ذلك كله عنا وعن أرحامنا وعن المسلمين. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك، وأغننا بفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم لا تحوجنا إلا إليك، ولا تذلنا إلا إليك. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا، وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. وصلي اللهم على محمد وآله وصحابته وتابعيه خير وأحسان.